is your thunder phone. We know. Have faith.
Jasmine, February 2018. all of seven. Open in prayer will be turned by faith, ever and ever.
Happy birthday. Father, thank you for today. Thank you for Easter. It can come to our family, Jesus.
Bye. We are standing before him and he is Dabi as we say, man. We are going to come and pray our recitation. One is entitled Mazemaze in last tense.
Thank you. in John. Stay here and keep watch with me as I go to pray. Father, if it is possible, take away this cup of suffering from me. Let your will be done, not my will. John, get up! Are you sleepy? Can you keep watch with me for an hour? Father, if it is possible, take away this cup of suffering from me. Let your will be done, not my will. Peter, James, and John, get up! Are you still sleeping? Can you make keep watch with me for an hour? Peter, the devil is asking for you, but I have already prayed for you. Stay, keep praying, watch for yourself. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Amen. The hand of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, 30 pieces. The one I will have in case is the one.
Father, wow. Away this cup of suffering from me. Let your will be done, not my will. Get up! Here come my betrayer! You are the king for John Winston,
brother.
Take him!
Siama, Siama, Kuka, Ewe, Kuka. Thank you. Oh,
Jesus' name.
Father, we say thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to be choosing among my friends. Thank you for allowing me to be counted among the living. I pray as I stay here, Lord, you anoint my labor, Lord, with your word that will be able to speak it out. Take care, take control, Lord. Take care, Lord. Worship and give you praise in Jesus' name.
If you have your power, please tell me to the book of 1 Corinthians 15, verse 1-4. Brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of the goodness I preached to you. You receive it and have put your faith in it. Because you believe the good news, you are saved. But you must fulfill it through the mission I preached to you. Every time you have believed it for nothing. Verse 3. What I receive, I pass on to you. And it is the most important of all. Here is what it is. Christ died for our sins. Just as scripture says, he was buried. He was raised from the dead. Just as scripture says, in Jesus' name. Let's read him. Our text, our team will be taking on the book. Our team will be. Don't forget Jesus.
Amen.
Remind us to not forget the message he preached and that we believe and trust it. We should hold on to it, for if we don't, our faith is finished. The message is that Jesus died, was buried, and rose on the third day. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Remind the people of this, Paul reminds the believers of him that they shouldn't forget and for the message they believed. The message that he preached to them, they trusted him. They put their faith into him. He reminded them to not forget. He told them that if they forget about that message, their faith is in him. Everything
didn't believe before is easy. And that good news or that message is Christ died. He was buried in his grave on the church day. So I'm here to remind you, the people of Commonwealth of Bowie County, don't forget about that message. Don't forget about that same message that Paul preached to the believers those days. If you forget that message, your faith is empty. You have pleaded for nothing in Jesus' name. And I hear the good news. And also, today is this one. We shouldn't forget Jesus. Let us be He was nailed on the cross for you and for me. So free up from sin. Even though Jesus never sinned, but he came to have the resurrection of conscience. According to Isaiah, Jesus was beaten. They mocked at him. They spit on him. He insulted him. They even spit on his side for our business. But Jesus remains quiet. Jesus was quiet when he was suffering. Jesus never fought back. My brothers and sisters, I'm here today to remind you, don't forget Jesus. Don't forget about the story Jesus told you. Today, fully as Christians, if we are there today, I want to let you know that Jesus came and gave everyone a mission. Jesus' mission was to die for us. I don't know what your mission will be, but if you need your mission, you need to be quiet. Jesus was quiet. When you are, you need not to forget about Jesus. If you suffering, whatever sickness it may be, don't forget about Jesus. Don't compare your suffering to Jesus' suffering. Because you are suffering for your own salvation. Jesus suffered for every one of us here. And you are suffering for your salvation.
Amen.
So today, everything that is holding you, my brothers and sisters, don't think that if you're suffering, you're suffering for Jesus. No way. You are suffering for your salvation. Don't compare yourself to Jesus. Jesus is your Savior. He shed so many of us for you to
have.
Yeah. That will not be yours. If you don't have food to eat or children, a lack of job, don't compare yourself to Jesus.
Yeah.
It cannot be compared to Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus name.
Amen.
Both that Jesus has every power, but he never, because he came to redeem us. He came to die for us and make the scripture come true. That was Jesus' mission.
Yes.
There's several reasons why, don't forget Jesus. Jesus' resurrection. So this fear us that they came. Pass it on to a brother. Yeah, yeah. Pass it on to a sister.
58. It tells us that Jesus has every power to heal, laugh, protect you. And because of his resurrection today, we have victory. We have freedom. It even gives us salvation. It makes us to be free of God forever. It gives us freedom. It even gives us hope to be free of God forever. Don't forget about Jesus. Today, as Jesus raised him from his dead, every day situation in your life, Jesus will write it. Every day situation that is holding you, every problem I tell you today, as Jesus resurrected, today he will resurrect your sickness.
There are many roads in my father's house. If this were not true, would I have told you that I am going there? Would I have told you that I will prepare a place for you there?
In Jesus' name,
amen.
Jesus tore up here his father's mansions. He had many rooms there for us. He says he will come back. He says he will come back to take up with him. My brother and sister, Jesus has given a huge promise. A promise to not forget. Jesus promised us that when he comes back, he will take all with him. And he also tells us, when he comes back, he is not coming for sinners any longer. Jesus is not coming for sinners any longer. Jesus is coming for people that accepted him. For people that hold on to him. For people that never forget him. For people that keep holding and faith and mercy. When Jesus comes back, those are people Jesus will take care of. Jesus is not coming back for us. Jesus is not coming back for a liar. He's not coming back for a fornicator. When Jesus comes back, he is coming to take the believers with him. For people that are prepared. If you're not prepared to go heaven, those are the two be locked in front of you.
You're
his thing. He gave us everlasting life. A life that's full of joy. A life that's full of peace. Happiness. There's no sicknesses. And if we want to have that everlasting life, you need not to forget about Jesus. You want to have that everlasting life, don't forget about his restoration. You want to have that everlasting life, don't forget how he died. He was waiting for us. And if you want to have that everlasting life, stop this shaming. Stop this smoking. So his promises. So you need not to forget his word. Hold on to your beliefs. With that, you will live forever. Eat you. Our Lord comes to thank you. Thank you for revelation, Lord. I pray, oh Lord, as I speak here to you, oh Lord, everything, oh Lord, that I've spoken, oh Lord, if something leaving your children here, oh Lord, let it carry on, oh Lord, don't forget Jesus, oh Lord. Lord, we pray as we go, oh Lord, you protect us, oh Lord, give us wisdom, worship, and give us praise. In Jesus' name.